Hi everybody, and welcome to another Fast Foundation Friday, where I always exceed my self-imposed limit of 2 to 3 minutes. So I would say a couple of weeks or maybe a couple of months ago, I got a request from somebody to explain why wearing plastic wrap underneath your corset might not be the best of ideas. Now, many years ago, I already made a couple of videos on the potential skin issues that may arise when you start wearing a corset, especially if you are not doing it in the most hygienic way. It could include bacterial and fungal infections because you are subjecting your skin to a moist, dark, anaerobic environment, and this is made worse with those kind of cinchers that you're designed to sweat in. There are ways to circumvent this, and I do mention a little bit about that in my corsets and skin issues video. Wearing a corset liner, making sure that you're clean and dry, wearing mesh corsets to keep you cooler and to let the sweat be able to evaporate better. Since annotations I think have gone away, I will link it up in the cards here or down in the description if you want to look at those videos. But in this video, I'm going to address the two biggest reasons why people say that they like to wear plastic wrap or other types of wraps around their waist, or they like to wear garments that cause them to sweat. The one reason is that they want to sweat out the fat and they think that it causes weight loss. The other reason they say is that it aids in detoxification. Okay, first of all, why sweating out the fat is not the best science. When I was a kid, I remember an adult saying to me, if you are not sweating while exercising, you're not working out hard enough and you're not burning enough calories. Now, when you're exercising, you're taking organic molecules of fat and sugar and combining them with oxygen that you breathe to transfer the energy in those bonds to ATP, which is your energy carrier, but it only exists for a very short amount of time. And that's why you store fat in the first place, because it's a very high efficient long-term form of energy storage. It's a reservoir of energy. But anyways, when you're exercising, then you convert ATP to ADP in free phosphorus and the energy to move your actin and myosin, making your muscles move. And this is an exothermic reaction. It's also a somewhat inefficient reaction, wherein part of the energy is lost as thermal energy, which we know as heat. So this causes your body to heat up during a lot of exertion, and then your body produces sweat in an effort to cool you down, because if you do not bring down your body temperature, then by about 42 degrees Celsius, your proteins are going to denature and stop working properly and you could die. So your body generating heat is more of a side effect of the exertion and the calories that you're already burning. Heating up your body temperature, if you're cold and shivering, for instance, can burn some calories, yes. So just because you're generating heat by wearing thermal wear does not necessarily mean that you're burning more calories. Then that section of your metabolism that was allocated to, raising your body temperature, preventing it from reaching room temperature and keeping it up to 37 degrees Celsius or 98.6 degrees Fahrenheit, that is no longer quite as necessary. So you might actually be burning fewer calories in the long run compared to if you were, just wearing something that allowed you to breathe. So if you imagine that your body is a machine, which it is, and your metabolism can be seen as the engine, an engine gets hot because it's working. But simply heating up an engine, if you put it into a bath or a room or, throw it into a volcano or whatever, simply heating up that engine is not going to cause it necessarily to work. So now let's talk about sweating and detoxification. There are some people who say that you can sweat out heavy metals and other types of toxins, which is to an extent true. But you have many other forms of detoxification before your skin comes into play. For instance, your microbiome. Let's say that you eat some toxins. Your microbiome, which is partially comprised of your beneficial gut bacteria, can actually help deactivate some toxins and prevent it from being absorbed into your bloodstream. So it can help, kind of prevent those toxins from getting into your body in the first place. If it does get absorbed into your intestines, then your liver should be able to filter out a lot of it. Anything you absorb from your gut goes through the portal vein and it goes to the liver first. The liver has like over 500 different roles in the body, and so it gets a lot of the first dibs on nutrients and other things. It also cleans and processes the blood before it gets into the rest of your body. So if the toxins still get through the liver on that first pass, don't worry, because your blood is constantly circulating, and so your liver can pick up those toxins on second and third and however many passes for the rest of your life. The kidneys do this as well. The kidneys are constantly filtering your blood and taking out certain toxins through your urine as well. So by the time that a toxin is circulating through your body long enough that it actually gets out of your bloodstream into your interstitial fluid to your dermis to be sweated out, it's probably been in your body for quite a long time, which means that your other detoxification methods might not be as effective as they should be, or your system might be overloaded by then. But that's not to say that the detoxification process through your skin is not important as well. So of course, sweating is good, but in a normal situation, you sweat and then it beads up and it rolls off of your body, or it evaporates into the air, or it gets wicked into absorbable fabric that you're wearing. But putting plastic wrap or unbreathable fabrics or other garments around your skin helps trap the sweat in. And that clamminess you feel when you take it off, it means that whatever you had sweated out before, you just turned around and absorbed back into your skin again. Just think about, you know, transdermal patches for, you know, say birth control or cortisone cream or other prescription topical medications. They get absorbed into your body. So who's to say that whatever you detox out of your body through your sweat can't turn around and be absorbed back in again if you are wearing something unbreathable against your skin for so many hours of the day. So unfortunately, you know, causing something to make you sweat, but keeping that sweat against your skin, it doesn't work the way that a lot of people think it does. But some people say that they wear plastic wrap or other types of wraps that cause them to sweat, and they have lost weight after a few days of doing this. So let's say that your sweat has been wicked away and it was not reabsorbed into your body. You've effectively dehydrated yourself, especially if you are the type of person to have a very low salt, low electrolyte diet, and also you are drinking a ton of water, like over a gallon of water every single day, and you are depleting your body of more electrolytes because you are forcing your body to pee it out. That is going to cause you to drop water weight and also temporarily relieve any edema in your skin. But if you drink some water, rehydrate your body, and take in electrolytes the way that your body wants you to, you will see the plumpness return to your skin. You'll see that weight come back. Remember when you see bodybuilders and fitness models, they spend a few days before their photo shoot or their competition deliberately dehydrating themselves so that the vascularity and the definition of their muscles can become more apparent. But then afterwards, they have to rehydrate. I would say a more effective way of sweating, if you're worried about detoxifying or whatnot, would just be to take a warm bath and just let the sweat, you know, go into the bath water. There are advocates out there who recommend sweating while in a relaxed state, because if you are under exertion and you are working out really hard and your sympathetic nervous system is activated, it may have a different effect than if you are just sitting in a sauna really relaxed. You are allowing your parasympathetic nervous system to take over, and this can lower cortisol levels and whatnot. But there are resources out there, so that's one other thing to consider. But so I really want to just cut off the video here because I think I've talked long enough. Let me know what you think in a comment down below. Once again, in case anybody was unclear, I do not recommend wearing plastic wrap under your corset or at all around your body for extended periods of time. So that's all for today. I will see you next week for another video. Thanks too much, guys. Bye.